Christ has risen. He has risen indeed. Happy Easter to everybody that is tuning in with us this morning. The only announcement that I have is that if you're going to do communion with us at the end of the service, you need to have your bread and your cup ready to go. And with that being said, worship begins as the prelude begins. Please join me for our call to worship. Glory to you, O God. On this day you won victory over death, raising Jesus from the grave and giving us eternal life. Glory to you, O Christ. For us and for our salvation you overcame death and opened the gates to everlasting life. Glory to you, O Holy Spirit. You lead us into the truth. Glory to you, O Blessed Trinity, now and forever. Hallelujah, Christ has risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
please join me in our prayer of confession. Almighty God, in raising Jesus from the grave, you shattered the power of sin and death. We confess that we remain captive to doubt and fear, bound by the ways that lead to death. We overlook the poor and the hungry and pass by those who mourn. We are deaf to the cries of the oppressed and indifferent to calls for peace. We despise the weak and abuse the earth you made. Forgive us, God of mercy. Help us to trust your power to change our lives and make us new, that we may know the joy of life abundant given in Jesus Christ, the risen Lord. Who is in a position to condemn? Only Christ, and Christ died for us. Christ rose for us. Christ reigns in power for us. Christ prays for us. Hear and believe the good news. In Jesus Christ, we are all forgiven. And let us pray. Almighty God, who taught us to pray not only for ourselves, but for people everywhere, hear us as we pray for others in the name of Jesus Christ. Inspire the whole church with your power, unity, and peace. Grant that all who trust you may obey your word and live together in love. Give grace to all who proclaim the gospel through word and sacrament and deeds of mercy, that by their teaching and example they may reveal your love for all people. Comfort and relieve, O Lord, all who are in trouble, sorrow, poverty, sickness, and grief, especially those weighing silently on our hearts, all those dealing directly with the coronavirus. Strengthen and fill them with your peace. May they be given all the resources they need to take care of themselves as well as those they are in charge of and care of. Help our leaders make wise decisions as they try to care for us. Be with those who are sick and unemployed. May they feel your presence and be comforted by it. Heal them in body and mind or circumstance, working in them by your grace wonders beyond all they may dream or hope. Bring to our remembrance all those who, having served you on earth, now sing your praises eternally. May their endurance give us courage and their faithfulness give us hope through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Glorious Lord of life, by the mighty resurrection of your Son, you overcame the old order of sin and death to make all things new in him. Grant that we who celebrate with joy Christ rising from the dead may be raised from death of sin to the life of righteousness. Through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. And we ask all this through the prayer your Son taught us so long ago. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious loving God, may the words, my mouth, and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable to you, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Our first scripture lesson today comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 28, verses 1 through 10. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descending from heaven came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, and he said, 'Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you.' So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, 'Greetings.' And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, 'Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me.'" This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Gospel of Matthew tells us of the morning after the Sabbath. It tells us that the Marys went to the tomb, and the tomb was empty. They were there when they took the Son of God off the cross and laid him in the tomb. They were there when they rolled that huge stone in front of the tomb. They were there that morning where they saw that the stone was rolled away. They were there at the entrance of the tomb, and they saw nothing. The tomb was empty. Emotions abounded: fear, loss, grief, hatred, anger, deception, and betrayal were just a few of the emotions that were felt that early morning. Jesus was dead, but where was his body? They were there at the tomb where the body of God's Son was laid just 3 days earlier. And today, the tomb was empty. This virus, this evil, life-threatening virus, is like an unwanted house guest that just doesn't know when to leave. Our fears are at their peak. We listen to the news and what our leaders have to say, yet they are saying something different than the doctors or the experts, the scientists. We look for guidance, yet all we have is more fear, anger, loss, hatred, and maybe even some feelings of betrayal. We see in real time pictures of emergency rooms filled with victims of the virus. We see refrigeration trucks because cities cannot keep up with the loss of loved ones. We see the despair when we wake up in the morning and when we lay our heads on our pillow at night. We keep hoping. Hoping the numbers will go down, that we hit that apex, that we start to flatten the curve and start to see a decline, but we keep waiting. We keep waiting for this time of isolation, this isolation from our friends and our family to be over. Just like the empty tomb, our churches are empty. Now, I love Easter. When I walk in on an Easter morning for the service, I have a little bit lighter step in my walk, and as I usually shout from the top of my voice, "Christ has risen!" And I always wait for the congregation to respond, "He has risen indeed," which I usually have to remind them to do that. I say it over and over again, "Christ has risen!" And you hear, "He has risen indeed, Christ has risen!" And I get louder and louder and louder. And that's exactly what happened today. When I was here first thing this morning in my introduction, I said, "Christ is risen." And there was silence from the four walls. As I look out over the pews, I see pictures instead of fancy hats and everyone dressed in their Easter best. I look out over the pews and I see empty seats where I would normally see people I have not seen since Christmas or even a welcome stranger joining us for the first time. I hear the organ bellow out, "Lift high the cross," that fills my heart. But I do not hear the loud voices singing those wonderful words. As we do the passing of the peace, there is no one to hug or to share that smile with. There is an empty space which once was full. However, just like the empty tomb did not have the final word 2,000 years ago, neither will our empty sanctuaries of 2020. What I have realized is that we, even though we may not be together on this Easter morning, in this place, in these four walls, singing loud praises to God and sharing the peace of Christ with one another, we have learned to be the church instead of being in the church. We have outstretched our arms at a 6-foot distance and relieved someone's fear. Maybe you called a friend and gave them comfort because a loved one may be sick. Or you may have even shared one of the sermon videos on our Facebook page or on our website when someone needed a calming, reassuring, or comforting word. The scriptures tell us to feed the hungry, and there are more people in need of nourishment now than in recent history. People are being the church in different ways, more than I could ever have imagined. Helping our local businesses in our small town as we order takeout, or tuning into worship services via Facebook or the website. Sharing our fears, our frustrations, our grief, and other emotions with one another, which may have never been done in the past. We have become a closer community of faith even when we are worshiping in our homes apart from one another. We have reached more listeners over the last few weeks than if we had just had our normal Sunday service in the church building. We have turned to God in our time of trials and tribulations instead of trying to fix things on our own. We have left our comfort zone of these four walls, and we now have neighbors checking in on neighbors. We hear of people who are less at risk going shopping for those most vulnerable. We have volunteers helping out the stranger. The village food pantry is there for all those who are hungry and in need, and no questions asked, no judgment, just a friendly smile as they make sure that everyone stays safe. The gospel is being shared, and more important, the gospel is being lived. We are the living gospel every day of this time of shelter in place. We have seen and heard that families are now sharing meals together again. Children are enjoying the outdoors, playing in their backyards, becoming creative again instead of playing on their Xbox boxes. I see families walking together in the local parks, flying kites together, a father and a small child playing catch. I see families becoming a family unit again, not all going in their separate ways. I see the simpler things in life, like puffy clouds in the sky as you look up and you see all the different animals and you share that with your children. I see the things that we used to take for granted become a foundation of new life in family. Just as the tomb was empty on that Easter morning so many years ago, and as our sanctuaries are empty this Easter morning in 2020, we still know in our hearts that Christ has risen. Christ has risen today. But we too have found a new life in our families, in our church, and in our lives. My friend Barbara Smith puts it best. The empty tomb was the beginning of what we know as redemption. May it be so for the empty church as well. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Christ has risen. He has risen indeed. Amen.
Please join me in professing what we believe by reading the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
Jesus said, "Come to me, all who are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled." Our Savior invites all those who trust him to share in the feast that he has prepared. Let us pray. You are holy, O God of majesty, and blessed in Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, whom you sent to save us. He came with healing in his touch and was wounded for our sins. He came with mercy in his voice and was mocked as one despised. He came with peace in his heart and met with violence and death. By your power, he broke free from the prison of the tomb, and at his command, the gates of hell were opened. The one who was dead now lives. The one who humbled himself is raised to rule over all creation, the Lamb upon the throne. The one ascended on high is with us always, as he promised. Nourished at this table, O God, may we know Christ's redemptive love and live a life and new life with him. Help us who recognize our Lord in the breaking of the bread to see and serve him in all whose lives are broken. Give us who are fed at his hand grace to share your bread with the hungry and with the hungry of heart. Keep us faithful in your service until Christ comes in final victory, and we shall feast with all of your saints in the joy of your eternal realm. Through Christ, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, Holy Church, now and forever. Amen. The Lord Jesus, on the night of his arrest, he took bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Every time you drink of it, do this in remembrance of me." And every time you eat of his bread or drink of his cup, you proclaim the risen Lord until he comes again. Please let us all be fed.
Beautiful. How beautiful the radiant bride who waits for her groom with his light in her eyes. How beautiful when humble hearts give the fruit of pure lives so that others may live. How beautiful.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you provide the true bread from heaven, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant that we who have received the sacrament of his body and blood may abide in him and he in us, that we may be fulfilled with the power of his endless love, now and forever. Amen. Christ has risen. He has risen indeed. Happy Easter, everybody. And as you leave this place, as you leave your living rooms, may the shalom of God, the love and passion of Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen.